This video tutorial, I will explain Spring Boot security for RESTful web service with database authentication. To enable Spring Boot security in pom.xml file, we have to add Spring Boot starter security. Here you can see users table, and it has two rows. The first username is Peter, and password is Peter123. In encrypted format, and second username is Dave, and password is Dave123 in encrypted format. To encrypt the password, I have used bcrypt password generator. So here you have to give the password and click on bcrypt, and whatever value you are getting, you can place it here and save the password. Here you can see Spring Boot demo application with the folder structure. Here you can see pom.xml file. Here you can see application.properties file. Here I have specified driver class name, URL of the database, and username and password of the database. Using this information, the Spring Boot application makes connection to the MySQL database. Here I have defined a class user controller, which is REST controller, and it has two methods, user validation and admin validation. To call this method, we have to send request to this path. To call this method, we have to send request to this path. Here I have defined a class Spring Security Config, and it is configuration class which extends Web Security Configure Adapter class. It allows us to override Spring Security default feature, and in this example, we will be enabling HTTP Basic Authentication, and which authenticates all the incoming requests. Here you can see configure AM builder method, which accept authentication manager builder, and in this method I am configuring JDBC based authentication and authorization. Here I am configuring which username and password combination can access the REST API endpoint, and here I am configuring which role can access the REST API endpoint. If you see in users table, there are two usernames are there, Peter and Dave, and role of Peter is admin, and role of Dave is user. Here you can see configure method which accept HTTP security. This method is used to configure HTTP security class which authorize all the HTTP incoming request. In this example, all the incoming HTTP request will be authenticated and allowed to access the REST API endpoint if user has user or admin role. In Spring Boot 2, we need to pass the encoded password. Here we have registered password encoder as a bcrypt password encoder, and while saving the password in database, we need to save it as a bcrypt encoded format, and that password will be decoded while authenticating. Here I have defined a class application, which is a Spring Boot application. I am starting the Spring Boot application. Spring Boot application is started in 8080 port. Using Postman client, I am going to send request to user login URL, and HTTP method is GET, and authorization I have selected basic authentication, and username I am passing as ROM, and password as ROM123. And if you see, username Rom is not configured in database. And I'm sending the request. And I got 401 unauthorized because that username password is not configured in the database. Next, I'm giving username as Peter and password as Peter123. Sending the request. Request reaches here. And here we got the output. Because the username Peter is configured in database. Next, I am going to send a request to admin login URL. Username as Dave and password as Dave123. Sending the request. Request reaches here. And here we got the output. The user Dave is configured in the database. You can get Java source code link from the description of the video. In mobile, to see the description, click on this icon. It will expand like this, and here you can see the description. It contains Java source code links. Click on these links to get the Java source code.